I think so. You all know your exam date, right? Yes. The exams are nearing. So please concentrate on your studies. Okay, students. Okay, now I'll tell you the marks. Okay, so just listen. Your summative assessment is for 60 marks. Your summative assessment is for 60 marks. So whatever the Google form test you have done previously, we will take it for 20 marks. Okay, the summative assessment is for 60 marks. And then Google form test, whatever you've done previously, we will take it for 20 marks. And then activity for 20 marks. So two activities for 20 marks. Just note down it, your summative assessment is for 60 marks and the Google form test which you have done previously, no? So that is for 20 marks, that is we will take it 20 marks from that, and then activity for 20 marks. So today we are going to do one activity. Totally two activity. One activity we are going to do it in class and another one activity I'm going to give it as a homework. Okay? Okay, now listen all of you. If you are having any paper with you, which means A4 sheet or any normal paper, if you are having, means all of you take it. Take your paper. Take your paper, all of you. After finish doing the activity, I will show you. I'll ask you to show you in the video. I'll ask everybody to show you in the video. I'm going to consider this as activity marks. Okay? Take one paper. Take one paper, all of you. Or otherwise, if you're having rough note, you can do the activity in the rough note. And then take two sketches or otherwise color pencils. Two color pencils. Any colors. Two color pencils or two sketches. Whatever you're having, just take it. If you don't have color pencils or sketches, use pencil, no problem. Okay? So only 10 minutes I'll give you. You have to finish the activity and you have to show it to me. Okay? I'll call out the names, you have to show it to me. So in that paper, write odd and even numbers. Just write odd and even numbers. Write neatly, do it neatly. So that I'll give you a good marks. Okay. Write odd and even numbers. You can use sketch. You can use color pencils. If you don't have anything, you just use pencil. Okay. No problem. Odd and even numbers. ODD. Odd and even numbers. Just write it. Write it as a heading. As a one line itself, you can write it. Odd and even numbers. Only 10 minutes time I'll give you. Finish it fast. So for odd numbers, we are going to draw a circle. For odd numbers, we are going to draw a circle. Okay? For even numbers, we are going to draw a triangle. For even numbers, we are going to draw a triangle. Okay? So you know what are the odd numbers. And then you all know what are the even numbers. What are the odd numbers? What are the odd numbers? 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. And then what are the even numbers? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Okay? Now you have to finish the activity and you have to finish. I don't have space on the board. Just wait. So for odd numbers, we are going to draw a circle. And then for even numbers, we are going to draw a triangle. Okay? For circle, you use one color. For triangle, you use one color. Okay? 1000. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 1 is an even number or odd number? 1 is an odd number, so you draw 1 circle. And then 3 is an odd number, so you draw 3 circles. And then 5 is an odd number, so you draw 5 circles. Okay? And then 7 is an odd number, so you draw 7 circles. So have you all understood? And then 9 is an odd number, so you draw 9 circles. And then we are moving on to even number. For even number, we are going to use triangle. So use triangle. For triangle, use any other color. Okay? So for 2 means you have to draw 2 triangles. And then 4 is an even number, so you draw 4 triangles. So have you all understood? Yes? I'll give you 5 minutes time. Come on, finish it fast and show it to me. I'm going to call one by one. You have to show it to me in the video. Okay? So see here? Like this, you have to draw and you have to show it. Like this, you have to draw and you have to show it to me. Come on, do it fast. If you don't have color pencils, don't have sketches, means you can use pencil, no problem. Finish it fast and show it to me. The first person is Alia. So Alia is going to draw first. So for odd numbers, you have to draw a circle, and then for even numbers, you have to draw a triangle. Okay? Come on, draw it and show it to me. Very good, students. All are doing it nicely. Very good. I'll ask one by one. So, Darun finished. Show me your paper, Darun. Finish, Darun. Yes, very good, Darun. Very good. And the next person, Sarlish Sultana, come on, show me. Sarlish Sultana, finish it and show me. Very good, very good. All are doing it nicely. Very good. And then Mugesh Adit finished. Mugesh Adit. Darun finished, very good. And then Sarlish Sultana, come on, show me. Come on, show me your notes, Sarlish Sultana. Yes, very good, Sarlish. And then Mugesh Adit, show me your note, Mugesh. Very good, Mugesh. And then who is the next person? Madhumita, come on, show me your note. Finish. Show me your note, Madhu. Very good, Madhu. Very good, Madhumita. And the next person, Adra. Adra finished. Very good. I not have any. Okay, Jessica Laughlin, no problem, no problem, Laughlin. And then Karthik Jeevan finished. Very good. And then Mokshita, show me a note. Mokshita, show me a note. Then Shyam Sundar. Very good. Ashish finished. Ashish. Okay, very good, Ashish. Smriti. Very good. Very good, Smriti. Sahitraj. Very good. Dikritik finish. Very good, Dikritik. If you write in your note also, no problem, students. You just show it to me, I'll give you marks. Okay. Sherlyn. Dakshita, show me a note. Dakshita. Someone show me a note, Dakshita. Yes, very good. Santosh. Santosh, come on, show me a note, Santosh. Yes, very good, Santosh. Srinika. Srinika. Yes, very good, Srinika. Samuel, come on, show me a note, Samuel. Jonathan. Show me a note. Oh, very good, Jonathan. And then BN. BN Niralya. BN Niralya. Yes, very good. Kartik Jeevan. Kartik Jeevan, very good. Mokshita. Yes, very good, Mokshita. Very good. Hari. Hari, very good. No problem, Sharini. You can show it in the afternoon class. No problem, Sharini. Alia. Latifa. Alia, very good. Latifa. Yes, very good, Latifa. So everybody finished? Everybody finished? You also finished? I noted all your names. Don't worry if I did not call your name, okay? I know those four are finished, okay? I have noted the names, okay? So don't worry if I did not call your name. I have noted all your names, okay? So everybody done nicely. Very good, students. Keep it up. Very good, students. Very good. So this activity is for 10 marks. You all finished? I think so, you all finished. Yes? So another one activity, I'm going to give it as a homework. Okay? Another one activity, I'm going to give it as a homework. If I did not call your name, don't worry, students. I have noted your name. Okay? So everybody did nicely. Very good, students. Very good. So we have only little time. So that's why I did not call your name. So don't worry. I have noted your name. So next one is ascending and descending order. This is, you have to do it as a homework. In the next class, I'll ask you to show you in the video. Okay? Just listen. Ascending and descending order. You just note it in your rough note. Okay? You just note it in your rough note. In the next class, I'll ask you to show you in the video, the next class, okay? Just write the heading, ascending and descending order. Ascending and descending order. Okay? Just write ascending and descending order. So ascending order means, we have to arrange the numbers from small to big. First side, ascending order means small to big. And then descending means We have to arrange the numbers from big to small. So take one paper, first write the heading, ascending and descending order. Okay? So just note down in the rough note. All of you just note down in the rough note so that it will be easy for you. Okay? First write the heading, ascending and descending order. And then ascending means you have to arrange the numbers from small to big. And then descending order means you have to arrange the numbers from big to small. Okay? Now listen. You have to draw it like this. This is number one. Ascending order means we have to arrange the numbers from small to big. This is two. And this is three. And this is four. And this is five. So ascending order means we have to arrange the numbers from small to big. This is ascending order. Okay? So ascending order will always be in increasing order. 1 and then it increases to 2 and then 3 and then 4 and then 5. So ascending order will always be in increasing order. So descending order means we have to arrange the numbers from big to small. So we have to draw an arrow mark like this. 5 and then it decreases to 4 and then it decreases to 3 and then it decreases to 2 and then it decreases to 1. So write descending order. And then write it is in decreasing order. Just note down in your rough note. Okay? In the next class, you do it in the A4 sheet and bring, okay? I'll ask you to show you in the video and I'll give you marks, okay? If you finish only, I'll give you marks, okay? So, grade 2 students are very good students, I know. So, finish it and bring, okay? You just give colors also, okay? You can give colors also. First, you have to write ascending and descending order. Ascending means small to big. Descending means big to small. And then you draw, okay? So 1, and then it increases, and then it increases, and then it increases, and then it increases. So ascending order means it will be in increasing order, okay? And then descending order means it will be in decreasing order, okay? So have you all understood? So now we'll move on to the sums, students. Can you say yes? We'll move on to the sums. So don't have time, I have to give you revision students. So just note down it fast. Okay. We'll move on to the sums now. The next class you show it to me. Don't want to show it now. Take a A4 sheet and do it very neatly. Okay. I'll give you marks for everybody. So don't worry. Okay. If I did not call you also, don't worry, okay? Because we don't have time, but we short time we are having. So that's fine, okay? Okay, students, now we move on to the sums. Next class is on Thursday, no? So Thursday, I'll ask you surely, okay? I'll ask you the activities to show you in the video, ascending and descending order. Okay, students. Okay, now listen, take a note and write revision, R-E-V-I-S-I-O-N, revision. Come on, write revision. Come on, write revision, all of you. Write revision. Write the place value of each digit. Write the place value of each digit. So place value means it represents the position of the digit in the number. For example, I'm giving you the number 278. For you have to write the place value 8 is in ones place, 7 is in tens place and 2 is in hundreds place. So this is the position of the digit in the number. So first, 8 is in ones place, so you have to multiply 8 into 1. So 8 into 1s are 8. And then in tens place, you're having the number 7. 7 is in tens place, so you have to multiply 7 into 10. So 7 into 10s are 70. And then in hundreds place, you're having 2. So 2 into hundreds are 200. So have you all understood? This is the place value of each digit. Place value of each digit means you have to find the position of the digit in the number. Okay? So have you all understood? Yes? Okay, we'll move on to the next cell. Next, write the face value. Face value means it is always the same digit itself. For example, if you're standing in front of the mirror, the same image will be reflected in the mirror. So for example, 562. So what is the face value of 2? The face value of 2 is? What is the face value of 6? Face value of 6 is 6. What is the face value of 5? The face value of 5 is 5. So have you all understood? Yes, students? Okay, we'll move on to the next sub. In 962, the place value and the face value of the digit 6 are. Of the digit 6 are. Come and find the answer and tell me. Digit R dash and dash. In 962, the place value. First, we have to find the place value of the digit 6. And then we have to find the face value of the digit 6. So where is digit 6 in the number? Digit 6 is here. So first write the place value, ones, tens, hundreds. So we are going to find the place value and the face value only for the number 6. So 6 is in tens place, so 6 into tens are 16. So the place value of the digit 6 is 16. Okay? And then face value. Face value of the number 6 is the same number, same digit, so 6. So have you all understood? Yes, students, we'll move on to the next sum. Okay. In digit, in 635, the digit 5 is in dash place. So digit 5 is in dash place. So whenever I'm giving you the question, first you have to write the place value. That is very important, okay? 5 is in ones place, 3 is in tens place, 6 is in hundreds place. 635, the digit 5. Where is 5 here? 5 is here. So digit 5 is in dash place. Come on, tell me. 5 is in ones place. So many are texting the answers correctly. So very good, students. Keep it up. Move on to the next sub. And then 640 equal to dash hundreds, 4 tens, 0 ones. Come on, give me the answer. 640 equal to dash hundreds, 4 tens, 0 ones. So first write the place value. 0 is in ones place, 4 is in tens place, 6 is in hundreds place. Come on, fill in the missing number. 6 is in hundreds place. So we have to write 6 hundreds and then 4 tens and then 0 ones. Next question is, so next we'll move on to comparing numbers. So what symbol is this? What symbol is this? This is greater than. In front, if the mouth is opened, it is greater than. And then what symbol is this? In the front, if the mouth is closed, means it is less than. And then this is equal to. And this is equal to. So now listen, 62-65. So what symbol we have to use it here? Come on, find it and tell me. First, write the place value. 2 is in ones place, 6 is in tens place, 5 is in ones place, and then 6 is in tens place. So come on, find it. First, look at the tens place on both the sides. Both the sides, the numbers are same. And then move on to the ones place. Ones place, the numbers are different. Now, which is the bigger number here? 2 or 5? 5 is the bigger number, so the mouth should open towards the bigger number. Mouth should open towards the bigger number. So which symbol is used in between the numbers? Come on, tell me which symbol is used in between the numbers? Greater than, or less than, or equal to? Come on, tell me. Less than, very good. So 62 is less than 65. This is less than symbol. When the friend, the mouth is closed, that is less than symbol. So we all understood? Yes, we move on to the next sum. 24 plus 3 - 22 plus 1. Come on, find the answer, all of you. 24 plus 3 - 22 plus 1. So if the number is given like this, means first you have to add the number. Come on, add the number and tell me what is 24 plus 3. 4 in the mind, 3 in the finger. After 4, 5, 6, 7. So 24 plus 3. What is the answer? 27. And then 22 plus 1, what is the answer? 23. So now you have to find the symbol. Okay? First you have to add the number and then you have to find it. So have you all understood? So first write the place value, ones, tens. And then write the place value, ones, tens. So look at the tens place. Both the sides are same. And then look at the ones place. Here you are having 7. Here you are having 3. Now, which is the bigger number here, 7 or 3? So, 7 is a bigger number. So, the mouth should open towards a bigger number. So, which symbol is used in between the number? Which symbol greater than or less than? In the front, it is open. The mouth is open. So, it is greater than. So, have you all understood? Have you all understood, students? Can you say yes? And then we'll move on to ascending and descending order. Sometimes the question will be asked like this. Write in increasing order. Increasing order means what? Ascending order will always be in increasing order. So write in increasing order, or arrange in increasing order, or arrange in ascending order. Any type the question will be asked. Okay? Write in increasing order. So increasing order means what? Ascending order or descending order? Can you tell me? Ascending or descending order? Come on, write it in increasing order. Increasing order means ascending order. Very good students. Come on, arrange it and tell me. I will ask anybody to give the answer now. Come on, Shivon, give me the answer for the sum, Shivon. Come on, Shivon, give me the answer for the sum, Shivon. Okay, ascending order means we have to arrange the numbers from small to big. Now, which is the smallest number here? 36. So, first write 36. And then, after writing this number, you just type out. And then, which is the smallest number here? 6 or 5. So 5 is the smallest number, so they can write 58. After writing this number, you just type up. And the remaining is 64, so they can write 64. Now check your answers. It is in increasing order. 36, and then 58, and then 64. So your answer is correct. So Shivon, finish. Finish finding the answer, Shivon. Write in decreasing order or descending order. Yes, Shivon. Write in decreasing order. Decreasing order means what? Write in decreasing order. Who is going to tell? Mahadi is going to tell. Write in decreasing order. For the same question, you are going to write. Same question. 58, 64, 36. Someone write in decreasing order. Mahadi is going to give the answer for the sum. Mahadi. Decreasing order means descending order. Descending order means we have to arrange the numbers from greatest, which means big to small. Now, which is the bigger number here? 5 or 6 or 3? 6 is the biggest number. So first write 64. After that, you strike off. And then which is the bigger number here? 5 or 3? 5 is the bigger number. So they can write 58. And then remaining is 36. So they can write 36. It is in decreasing order. First it is in 64 and then 58 and then 36. So I hope so you all understood. Yes. So the next question, Subiksha is going to give the answer for the next sum. Write in descending order. Next, Subiksha is going to give the answer. Write in descending order. 236. And then 243 and then 228. Someone find the answer and tell me, Subiksha. I want everybody to find the answer. Come on, give me the answer, Subiksha. For everybody, I'll give you a chance to them. So don't worry, okay? 236, 243, 238. Come on, write in descending order. Or otherwise decreasing order. Okay. First write the place value. Ones, tens, hundreds. So that it will be very easy for you. So which I finished finding the answer. Come on, arrange it and tell me. Now which is the bigger number here? Descending order means big to small. Now which is the bigger number here? The first 243 is a bigger number. After writing this, you just type up. And then which is a bigger number here? 3 or 2. So 236 is the next biggest number. So just type out after writing this. And reminding us, 228. Everybody finish? Everybody finish finding this answer? So grade 2 students are cooperating very nicely. Very good students. Okay, in the next class, don't forget to finish the activity. Okay? Don't forget to finish the activity. Okay, students. Bye-bye. Take care. Stay safe.